Hello students, today we will discuss transport phenomena, viscosity. I am Dr. S.B. Kolle, Department of Physics, Shivaji Arts, Commerce and Science College, Kannur, District Aurangabad. So you know friends, according to kinetic theory of gases, molecules of gas are always in state of thermal agitation, they are moving randomly in zigzag motion. And transport phenomena such as viscosity, conductivity, diffusion occur only in non-equilibrium state of gas. So see here, transport of momentum gives rise to phenomena of viscosity. Transport of heat gives rise to phenomena of thermal conductivity. Transport of mass gives rise to phenomena of diffusion. Now in this presentation, we will see transport of momentum viscosity. So see friends, you know, if this gas is moving, then different layers of gas have different velocities. Such a gas is taken in this figure, see here, the gas is moving from left to right along OX surface, horizontal surface. Now here the gas layers are shown. Here three layers are taken for study. Here EF layer is shown, here AB layer is shown, CD layer is shown. Now friends, you know the layer which is in contact with this OX horizontal surface has zero velocity, and as we go along OZ, velocity of layers increases. Means this CD layer has less velocity than AB layer, and this EF layer has greater velocity than AB layer. Means as we go along OZ in this direction, positive direction, we observe that velocity of gas increases. You see, EF layer and AB layer are at a distance lambda, AB layer and CD layer are at a distance lambda. This lambda is mean free path. The velocity of AB layer is V, velocity of EF layer is V plus dU by dz into lambda, velocity of CD layer is V minus dU by dz into lambda. So now molecules of gas are moving in all directions due to thermal agitation. So average number of molecules along any one of one axis, means along positive direction or negative direction, it is 1/6. Number of molecules per unit volume is N. Mass of each gas molecule is m, and c is the average velocity of gas molecule at a given temperature of the gas. So number of molecules passing downward from EF to CD layer per unit area of AB in 1 second is NC/6. See, molecules passing means molecules from EF layer passing towards CD layer crossing this AB layer. So it is NC/6. So forward momentum lost per unit area per second by layer EF is m into NC/6 into V plus dU by dz into lambda. Here mass of molecules into velocity, this is momentum. Number of molecules passing upward from CD to EF layer per unit area of layer AB in 1 second. Now see friends, the molecules are passing from CD layer to EF layer crossing this AB layer. So it is NC/6 again. So forward momentum gained by layer EF per unit area per second is m into NC/6 into V minus dU by dz into lambda. So if we have to calculate net momentum loss by layer EF per unit area per second, we have to take difference of these two momentums, momentum lost and gained by the layer EF. So we will do this, MNC/6 into bracket V plus dU by dz into lambda minus V minus dU by dz into lambda. So after simplification, we get 1/3 MNC lambda into dU by dz. The CD layer below AB layer again same amount of momentum. Now backward dragging force per unit area is equal to gain or loss of momentum per unit area per second. So this force, 1/3 mnc lambda into d by dz, and this viscous or tangential force, eta into d by dz, is equal to this force, 1/3 mnc lambda into d by dz. So after simplification means this d by dz term will get cancelled. So we get eta is equal to 1/3 mnc lambda. So eta is equal to 1/3 rho c lambda, because this mn is density of gas, rho. Now we will see effect of temperature on eta and effect of pressure on eta. First of all, we will see effect of temperature on eta. You know density rho decreases with increasing temperature, and lambda mean free path increases in same proportion, so that rho lambda product remains constant, and c is proportional to under root t, you know, temperature, velocity proportional to temperature. So eta is directly proportional to under root of t. So coefficient of viscosity eta increases with increase in temperature. Now this effect of pressure on eta, you know, density increases with increase in pressure, and lambda decreases in same proportion, so that rho lambda product remains constant. So coefficient of viscosity is independent of pressure. Eta is equal to 1/3 rho c lambda, you know. So eta is independent of pressure. Reference I used for preparation of this PowerPoint presentation. Thank you.